Hello everyone and welcome back with Next.js playlist. Okay, so in this video what we are going to talk about is the quick recap. Okay, what we have done till today. So we talked about Next.js, the basic building blocks, now how to actually connect Next.js with the MongoDB, which is same as just use a Next.js Mongoose module and just have your Docker container for MongoDB up. Okay, so what all things we have done till these 10 videos which we have covered about Next.js is we talked about how to connect to MongoDB, what are the building blocks of Next.js. Next.js is nothing but a framework built on top of Express.js of Node.js. Okay, so Node.js is obviously a primary technology. Here Next.js is just a library, or you can say a framework, which is built on top of Express. It is just giving you the TypeScript safety, and it is built on top of Express, giving the same modular style which we are having in Angular. So it is like for front-end developer, it's, you can say it is a back-end framework for front-end developer who are already working with Angular. I mean, not for them only, but they will find the code very similar, because we are creating modules, we are creating services, we are injecting them, and all these things, all these concepts look similar. Okay, we were using Docker. So Docker is nothing big. We are just spinning up two containers. One is a Node.js container, one is a MongoDB container. And Node.js container is talking to the MongoDB container to deal with the data. Okay, so we have done in the first 10 videos, we just set up all these things. In the last video, we wrote this auth controller where we had this login and register APIs. Okay, and we have created these models, like we just have a user model right now. And how we are bootstrapping these modules, we are just providing the mongoose module.4 root. So this line is helping me to talk to MongoDB database. Here you can say when I'm doing a Docker compose up, I'm able to connect to the MongoDB. MongoDB dependency is initialized. That means we are good. We are able to connect to the MongoDB. Now in the separate modules, you might be writing the user module, auth module, product module, order module, because we are creating a modular structure of application. So you can access a particular MongoDB schema, like I think we are doing something here. So this is our auth service. We have created one service where we are injecting our schema. So just checking that. App controller we had, app module, so this is where we are injecting. And in the auth controller, we are trying to access the user service, and in the user service we are accessing some methods. Okay, and what else we have created is shared controller. Yes, this is what I was talking. Once you have initialize the MongoDB in the root module, now you can access a MongoDB schema like this. Inject model, I want to access user model, and this dot user model will give me all the methods. This dot user model dot find, find by ID, find by ID and update, find by ID and delete, all the MongoDB methods I will be able to access. Okay, this is service. So I'm injecting the user schema model. Now once this step is done, now you can inject these particular schemas in your services. Like I'm talking user service, so I will be injecting a user schema model in the user service, so I will be able to access all the methods related to the user model. Similarly, you will be writing a product and order, there you will be injecting a inject model product model and just model of that product, then you will be accessing all the methods on that. We created some building blocks like exception filter, logging interceptor, and some JWT strategy service for the auth controller. Like when you are doing login, what we are doing, if we are able to find the user is there available, then we are just creating the payload and we are sending the token to the user in the request. Okay, so this is the basic DTO we have created. We also talked about the role of DTOs is used for validation. Here you can use a class validator and can specify that username and password are required. So whenever we are passing these data, then we might be validating the data. Okay, so so here we can just see where is our user controller. So currently we don't have a much content inside it. We are just doing a ping and we are doing it. So we'll be binding all the methods of user, like get user, update user, delete user, and all the login related controllers like login, register, forget password, reset password, we can bind in our auth controller. Okay, so this is just a quick recap what all we have done. We talked about the pipe, interceptors, how to create module, how to create controllers and services, how to inject services into a controller, and then how to write routes inside a controller. Before that, we created a Swagger module, which is giving us nice and clean way of getting the documentation for our APIs. In shared module, we have just an interceptor logger. Okay, and these are the schema models we have. That's it. I think this is what we have done till today. This is controller, services, user module. For everything, we have created a separate modules, like for user-related APIs, user module, auth-related API, auth controller. So you can see auth module I'm doing. Inside auth module, I'm not directly accessing the user schema model. Otherwise, I can, if you wanted to access something related to the user schema, then you can import it here. Okay, there are additional, so this is import. Okay, so here I'm using mongoose module.4 feature. I will just import this and user schema too. Now might be in some services of auth service, I will be able to inject the user schema model and I will be able to access the method. So I will be creating a product model, order model, user model. User model is already there. Here I'm injecting this schema. So this is accepting an array. So you can pass all different schema models you wanted to use in this particular module. So we are going to create a modular approach. And in the coming videos, what we will have is we will have an order, product, and user. We'll have them associations between them. Okay, user will be doing order. Order will be associated to some product, and user will be getting that product. So it's like what we are talking here is Nest.js Mongo with the Docker. Okay, once we are done with this whole setup of three schemas and different APIs, what we will change to, we will move to Nest.js with the MySQL, and here we are going to have MySQL tables, and we will take either e-commerce system or some other blog, user blog comment system. Okay, thanks everyone. In the next videos, we'll just talk about more on the Nest.js. Thanks.